So the next question is on, okay, it's on probability. So what is given here? If 5 balls are picked at random, what is the probability that at least one is black? So let us look at the quantity 1. So what have they given? 5 balls are picked at random. Totally how many balls are there? 15 balls are there. Okay, out of this 15 balls, I am picking 5 balls. What is the probability that at least one is black? So probability that at least, okay, one is black is nothing but, how do I get that? That is equal to 1 minus the probability that no black is picked. Correct? This will give me the probability that at least one black is picked. So what is the probability that no black is picked? See, totally out of the 15 balls, I am picking 5 balls. So in what is probability? What is the formula for probability? The favorable cases divided by the total number of cases will give you the probability. Okay, so here, what is the total possible ways in which I can pick 5 balls from 15 balls? I can do that in 15C5 ways. Basically, I select any 5 balls from the total 15 balls. Now, my required case is wherein I am not picking any black. So what does that mean? See, I leave out the 6 black balls that are there. Other than the 6 black balls, there are how many other color balls are there? 9. Correct? There are, see, other than the 6 black balls, there are 9 other balls. So if I pick any of these 9 balls, my condition is satisfied. So the required probability that no ball is black is being picked is 9C5 minus 15C5. So the required probability that at least one black ball is picked is 1 minus this. Okay, now let us look at what quantity 2 is. Quantity 2 says, if 3 balls are picked at random, what is the probability that none of it is green? Again, out of a total of 15 balls, I am picking, selecting 3 balls. Correct? Now, probability that none of it is green is what? When I am not picking these 3 green balls and I am picking any other of these balls. Basically, out of this 15, I can pick any of these 12 balls. I cannot take this 3 balls alone. So here, this is nothing but I am picking 3 balls out of this 12 balls. Correct? So that is my required probability here. Now, here if you see 12C3 by 15C3. Correct? So I hope you know the formula for combinations, right? See, NCR. I'm sure all of you know this, n factorial by r factorial into n minus r factorial. So here, if you see 9C5 by 15C5, so this will be equal to 1 minus 9 factorial by 5 factorial into 9 minus 5, that is 4 factorial divided by 15 factorial by 5 factorial into 10 factorial. So actually this will become, see this 5 factorial will get cancelled here, correct? So you will actually have 6 into 7 into 8 into 9 divided by, that 1 minus I have not taken for now, okay? Let that be there. Divided by 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. Then you will have here, you will have again 15 factorial by 10 factorial. So you will be left with 11 into 12 into 14 into 15 divided by 1 into 5. Correct? Now, if you take it that side and multiply, actually these terms will get cancelled. Now, then you will be left with 6 into 7 into 8 into 9 divided by 11 into 12 into 13 into 14 into 15. Okay? So, this 5, you can take it up. Correct? When you are cross multiplying. So, this will be in the numerator. This will be in the denominator. Basically, I am taking this up. So, this will come in the numerator. This will go to the denominator. So, if you do that also, I'm just trying to eliminate as many values as I can. So big values, here you have 15 by 5, 3. So basically the number that you will have here will be 8 into 9 divided by 11 into 13 into 12. Okay, something like this. Now what I'm saying is don't try to calculate this further. Let that be there. So the answer that you are going to get is 1 minus 8 into 9 divided by 11 into 13 into 12. Okay, now here you have to do 12C3 by 15C3. Again, when you do 12C3 by 15C3, follow the same method, you will get something like this, 44 by 91. Just check, you should get this. Okay, if you want, let me do it also here. So you will have 12 factorial by 3 factorial into 12 minus 3, that is 9 factorial. Oh, sorry, divided by, you have 15 factorial by 3 factorial into 15 minus 3, that is 12 factorial, correct? So again, you can cancel out 9 factorial will go here. You will have 10 into 11 into 12 by 1 into 2 into 3. So again, you can cancel this here. This will be 13 into 14 into 15. Okay, even if you cross multiply it and write, you will get the answer as 44 by 91. Now, see, when you look at this number 44 by 91, what can you say? See, the answer is, see, 45 into 2 is 90. Correct? So basically, 44 by 91 is definitely going to be less than 0.5. You needn't actually calculate the exact value. You know this is going to be less than 0.5. Okay? Now, when you look at this term, correct? See, you have 1 minus 8 into 9 divided by 11 into 13 into 12. Okay, so the denominator, if you see here, is a very huge number. Correct? See, even if you take an LCM here, the answer that you are going to get is 11 into 13 into 12 minus 8 into 9 divided by 11 into 13 into 12. This answer that you get is definitely going to be greater than 0.5. No doubt about that. Correct? When you look at the value itself, you know it's going to be greater than 0.5. So what can you say? You can directly say that this quantity is definitely going to be greater than quantity 2. Okay, so you can take the answer as option